Hi, this is Mike Cucciarelli, and today we're going to talk about how I use, props with the black plexiglass tube. Today I'm going to show you all the props, but I'm not necessarily going to use all the props. First are the big ones, like, these are gold silver cards. These are other big silver cards. Silver cards are great for, bouncing light in a dramatic way. And then we have a silver card, have a white screw reflector. I also have a gold that bounces some yellowish tints. I have other reflectors. I have a silver reflector. I have a white screen reflector. I have the gold. So I'm going to take this off. I can put it over here, make the light more smooth. And these are, very big white cards. These are very big black cards. There's many ways to use this and still have the target with any table. And these are scrims where you can just lean against the strobe. And these are smaller scrims. These are red gel. These are gels. There are many colored gels. These are gold cards. These are silver cards. And these are black cards if you want to block layers. These are other gels. These are white cards, foam white cards, great for any light. You can use it as a blocking light. And these are just paper, paper clips, clothing pins, where you just attach the gel on the strobe. These are spring clamps. Many ways you can use it to hold up a wall. And this is like an aluminum bowl where it's great for portraits. It's also great for product where the light bounces off, the shiny silver. These are folding mirrors. You want to bounce in light. Over here. These are armature clamps where I'm going to attach a mirror plate. I'm going to just bounce in light. And these. This is called a snoot, where you want to put in light in a dramatic way. You put the gels in to color up the flash. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to put some blue gel. And I'm going to have a nice blue background. I'm just using, you know, paper clip, I mean clothing pins to hold up the gel. What I'm going to do is, I'm going to be doing tethered capture, where I'm going to be sending files to Lightroom through this technique. I'm going to do is I'm going to raise. You need more light from the back. I'm going to raise it all the way up to 6. Now we can also, we can make the light this out of the way. So how many things you can do with one light? Move it away, you can move it closer. Now I'm going to go to the other computer. I'm going to work on the exposure. I'm going to raise the aperture to 8. We're getting there. Still see a glare. I can fix this in Photoshop. I'm at 5.6.
There's other ways you can do this too. Or does it take away the black? Great card for the white balance. Make sure
for the lightest traits. I'll take a shot again. Now what I'm going to do, I'm going to work on tethered capture in the other computer. Now, what I want to do is by easy control the line with black cards, we'll get that next shot. And that's going to be the next shot, so we're going to. Okay, now, there's another shot we're going to. I could use a prop to add lights. It's probably not enough. That's where you got to get a second light. Where we're going to work it. So now what we're going to do is we're going to use a strobe. Shadows, and I want to put light, so I make put character to the subject. Sometimes you can even use a double scrim effect. Two strings. That's what you like. I'm going or the other computer. Now I'm going to adjust the exposure. We're going to go from aperture 8 to aperture 11. Then we're going to go from aperture 11 to aperture 16.
A little more light here. So what I'm going to do, then another light, I'm going to put a bounce in light to get more detail in the shadow. Raises up. Now I'm going to adjust the exposure on the computer. I'll test out the flash.
Now I'm going to get more detail. I'm going to just wide it into the stop.
I'm going to use this one. I made that. With the gray card and the color correction. So now we're going to do another one. We're going to turn this off. Take this away. Now we're going to get the snoot out. Remember, you can't put gels inside here. I don't. That's how I do it. You can. I'm going to turn on my strobe. I think I just want to raise the strobe. Stop. I'm going to get closer. Go here. Here's the point. This is the most important part, so is that. So I'm going to try to do. Trying to make it even as best as I can. So what I want to do also this glare kind of bugs me.
kind of took out the glare. I'm going to try with... I use a black horn to take out the glare in product photography. Now I just want to try angling the light. Now what I could do, I could put double screw here too. Now what I'm going to do, I'm going to do one with the gray part because I like food. Next part of the lab, we're going to talk about how to shoot a glass clear subject without this. So I'm going to turn off the strobe. Now, okay, the very first thing we're going to do is again, what we're going to do go over the props again. We have big gold cards and silver cards. These are great for adding light in a dramatic way. We have, you know, big white cards. You can use them any ways. We can have big black card for taking away lights. We have big, you know, a silver reflector where bouncing dramatic light, bouncing soft light. And we have big scrims. You know, the same thing in this, you know, we could put a double scrim. We could, and today, we're first going to start and turn on the strobe. I'm just going to use a dark color. Red could be a tricky color to work with, but red could be a great color to work with. And if you want to make an orange, use I'm going to power up my strobe all the way. This is another shot. We're going to get to it soon. Right now, I just want to, you know, so this is glass. So the light will shine right through the glass. I'm going to shut down my light. So I'm going to go to my tethered computer, my tethered capture with Lightroom. Okay, it's overexposed. Now we gotta work on the light. The goal is to produce like a nice vignetting background, also a nice kind of red backgrounds. Okay. I'm trying to produce some funky colors, yeah. I think I'm going to do this is I'm working my gels. There we go. I got an interesting I'm gonna just see if I can move the
Much better. And just by moving the light like 10 inches away, we get a much dramatic photograph.
So now I'm going to try moving the light even further. Because just by moving a light by 10 inches, 12 inches, you get a different type of photograph. Just by moving the light.
Ah, I like that.
Now, if you want to add lights with mirrors, try just adding a light with the reflector. Sometimes, you know, you just need to get a second light out. Now we're going to work on another shot where it's difference. Okay. Where I'm going to do this. Take this down, I'm going to lay at a 45 degree angle. Or CG clamps to hold this up, and now I just rest against the pole. But we're going to do something a little different for the effect I like. We're going to have a double scrim effect. Double scrim. So what I'm going to do, I'm going to make sure that this light is parallel to this. Where this light is parallel to this, I'm using a double scrim, but what we're going to do, we're going to photograph a watch, and then we're going to get a black card and block out the glare. We're going to have an interesting angle. I'm going to make sure that the light hits the watch. Now we got to angle the camera. So we still got work to do in this photograph. Now, this is
But I want to try to get more detail. That's where I may try to use, you know, yeah, I want a shadow in the photograph, but I want detail on that shadow. I'm trying to move closer in. It's... wherever exposed, I do see some detail on the shadow. Now, I'm going to see if I can cut my shutter in half by going from 1/25th to 2/50th. So a little overexposed. From 16 to 22. Now the problem is, this strobe is just too powerful. So we're going to take down two stops of light from 6 to 4. I'm going to change up my aperture. So I'm going to work on the exposure on the computer. We're getting better. I like the exposure. I'm trying to get more details in the shadow. I'm going to go from F16 to F11. I'm going to go back to 16. I like that better. Sometimes you get detail in the shadow, you just need another light. You can try a bigger reflector. Sometimes you just need to get a second light. That's where but the light's probably too powerful. So I'm going to put a scrim in front of the strobe.
I also want to do this is I feel like there's too much of a glare in the wash. So I want to block some of the, you know, a black card, I want to block some of the glare. Trying to find my cable release. Still a little overexposed. I'm gonna try to get a bigger black card. Head is the most important part. So what I want to do, I want to knock out the glare. Looks more pleasing to the eyes. And then I'm going to put back I'm going to make the lip more softer. So I think I'm going to I want my light to be even. I'm going to go back without the black card. I'm going to raise the aperture from 22. So, I like this card better because I felt like the other black card was taking on too much light. Okay. Maybe I could just take away. I'm going to try to fill in more detail over here. Details in shadow. We'll do one more shot. I'm going to retire the strobe for a little bit. One more shot I want to do. Where I want to use with these expansion poles. We're going to do this. We're going to have a big scrim softening this light, a big scrim softening that light. Now we're going to use this where we're going to do this a little differently where turn on two strobes. So I got work to do in this photograph. Just my Plexiglass.
I'm trying to move it closer to camera.
So light. And even bouncing light in the shadow part. It's way underexposed. I had the aperture of 22. So I'm going to just go to F8. I'm going to try F16. Trying to work in the exposure in the computer. Now I'm going to lower the strobe. I stop a light. I'm sure the best at 3. Okay. And they go to the computer. Also, we need to also get lower. You need to angle it better. Okay, that's better. Still got a glare. So now Yeah, I'm trying to find where the glare is. So now, I'm going to use a spring clamp. My goal is to knock out some glare. I'm using, you know, spring clamps. I'm trying to like control the glare with two black cards. Not bad. Add in more light. I'm going to go from 8 to 5.6. Ah, we're talking. It looks better. Gotta clear up the backgrounds. Not bad. Like this one, so we're going to use it. All right. So that concludes the lab with a demo of my course props with being used with the black plexiglass table. Thank you for watching, and many updates on my YouTube channel. So maybe consider liking and subscribing. Thank you for watching. And I will post the recording of this on my YouTube channel if you need to watch it again. Thank you again.